الذين آمنوا وتطمئن قلوبهم بذكر الله، ألا بذكر الله تطمئن القلوب.
أصبحنا وأصبح الملك لله والحمد لله، ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر، ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We just finished صلاة الفجر جماعة. May Allah سبحانه وتعالى make it in our حسنات. أمين يا أرحم الراحمين. من علامات توفيق الله سبحانه وتعالى للعبد، some of the signs or one of the signs of the توفيق or the success of the servant of Allah سبحانه وتعالى that Allah سبحانه وتعالى give it to him. الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد ومن يتق الله يجعل له مخرجا ويرزقه من حيث لا يحتسب. Whosoever fears Allah عز وجل, Allah will find a way for him to get him out from his difficulties. And Allah will make his task and his affairs easy. Allah سبحانه وتعالى. من علامات توفيق الله سبحانه وتعالى للعبد that Allah سبحانه وتعالى gives him success. First of all, سبحان الله، الله سبحانه وتعالى سيد ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. If you obey Allah سبحانه وتعالى and his رسول محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم following his sunnah, this is the ultimate success, دنيا and the akhirah. They call it الفلاح. That Allah سبحانه وتعالى is calling you to الفلاح 5 times a day. حي على الفلاح. When Allah said in the azan, حي على الفلاح, this is the ultimate success. Not in نجاح. نجاح في الدنيا to have money, to have business, to have this call نجاح. But الفلاح في الدنيا والآخرة both. That's why Allah is calling you حي على النجاح ولا على الفلاح. الفلاح. This is the ultimate success, دنيا and the آخرة. أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه narrated that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, إذا أراد الله بعبد خيرا استعمله. فقيل كيف يستعمله يا رسول الله؟ قال يوفقه لعمل صالح قبل الموت. ده صحيح الأرواء رواه الإمام الترمذي حديث. الله سبحانه وتعالى loves someone. الله سبحانه وتعالى will use him. ده سيد يا رسول الله how Allah can use him. Can use him. He said Allah will give him توفيق هداية. Allah will get him to make some righteous good deeds before his death. Before his death or her death. This كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. وعن أبي بكرة عن أبي أن رجلا قال يا رسول الله أي الناس خير؟ أمان أسكت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم who is the best amongst us in the community, who is the best person يا رسول الله؟ he said من طال عمره وحسن عمله. If Allah gives you long life while you're doing righteous good deeds, this is the best صلى الله عليه وسلم said. And he said فأي الناس شر؟ who is the worst, the bad person؟ سبحان الله. He said من طال عمره the one Allah gives him long life وساء عمله while he's doing bad deeds. This person يعني is so bad. Imagine that if somebody became like 90 or 100 and he's still doing bad deeds. Is it the شر الناس هذا؟ That's why the hadith said Allah سبحانه وتعالى the most he hates الشاب الزاني. If somebody young and he's making adultery and zina, Allah hates him. And Allah hates more الشيخ الزاني. Somebody very old and he's still making zina or haram. خربان. Oh, what are you waiting for? سبحان الله. You know, that's why. ومن علامات توفيق العبد if Allah سبحانه وتعالى give you ability to seek knowledge. What is knowledge? علم الشرعي, علم الدين. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will give you. قال من يريد الله به خيرا يفقهه في الدين. If Allah intend to make خير for you and good for you, Allah will give you understanding of your deen. الفقه is understanding. الحكمة is understanding. When you understand your deen. Also, if Allah سبحانه وتعالى give you ability to make دعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى and teach people الخير, like the mission. What was the mission of the prophets and messengers of Allah? To teach people the deen and the خير and the دعوة إلى الله سبحانه وتعالى. That's why Allah سبحانه وتعالى said clearly in Surah Fussilat, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَوْلًا مِمَّنْ دَعَى إِلَى اللَّهِ. حتى الآية دي نزلت في المؤذنين, بس in general not just for the مؤذن. The one is calling people to Allah, in general, anybody is calling others to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, this is the best work and the best job and the job of the prophets and messengers. فمن اتقى وأصلح فلا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. If you fear Allah and you're making salah, righteous good deeds, means you're calling people or showing people for ma'ruf, there is no fear and there is no sadness for these people. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He's the one who gives. If Allah gives tawfiq to you and success, and Allah guides you to make tawbah, the honest tawbah, this is also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is alamat al-khair. والله يريد أن يتوب عليكم ويريد الذين يتبعون الشهوات أن تميلوا ميلا عظيما. Allah loves you to make توبة and Allah سبحانه وتعالى guides you to make توبة. But those شياطين الإنس, those who are following their inner desires, they want you to be follow them. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى more you make توبة more will be so happy of you. لله أفرح بتوبة عبده من أحدكم في أرض فلا. إلا من تاب وآمن. يبقى توبة followed with إيمان أن عمل صالح righteous good deeds وعمل عملا صالحا فأولئك يبدل الله سيئاتهم حسنات وكان الله غفورا رحيما. And he said وإني لغفار لمن تاب وآمن وعمل صالحا ثم اهتدى. الله said وإني indeed I am غفار يعني فعال. I am the all forgiving all the time to those who make توبة with إيمان believing in the oneness of Allah and they followed their إيمان with righteous good deeds. And these people will be guided. All this will lead them to be guided. Also, علامات توفيق العبد خدمة الناس. If you serve people, if you help people, this also, if you do that, this is Allah سبحانه وتعالى really, He loves you and He will, يعني سبحان الله, will put you in the good way, inshallah. قالوا يا رسول الله, أي الناس أحب إلى الله? Who is the most beloved to Allah, يا رب, يا رسول الله? And what is the most beloved deed to Allah, يا رسول الله? He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, أحب الناس إلى الله, أنفعهم للناس, the most beneficial to others, these people, Allah سبحانه وتعالى loves them so much. And the most beloved good deed to Allah سبحانه وتعالى, سرور تدخله على أخيك المسلم. When you make your brothers in Islam happy, yes. Yeah, instead of giving him miserable time or life, make him happy. They know, يا أخي, smile. To him. Yeah, give him a joke. Why not? It's halal joke, يعني. Yeah, subhanAllah. Some people, they are miserable. Whenever you see them, أعوذ بالله. Some, he's going to give you something negative. Maybe he's going to talk about the clothing you're wearing. The way you talk, maybe he can say, brother, why you talk like this? Negative. He never look at the good side of you. He look at the negative side of you. These people, haram to touch him. Haram to talk to them. Haram, fatwa from me, to talk to them. I call them, even Sheikh Ali Al-Qarri in his book, Tahzan, Don't Be Sad, he mentioned them, and they said, they are the carriers of al-humum. Hamalat al-ahzan. They are the carriers of sadness and grieving and sorrow and all of this. They are negative. Big, bad X, put just X on them. فحرام to talk to these people, because then I'm going to give you more load of al-ahzan, sadness and negative things. For these people, no, be away from them. Smile. See, make some jokes. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he used to have sense of humor. Even Allah Almighty has sense of humor. Allah, yes, there is a hadith. Allah will laugh at his abd in the day of judgment, the one who will be out of hellfire, last one. Allah will give him a joke. They said, أَتَهْزَأْ بِي وَأَنْتَ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. The guy, خربان, he said, are you laughing at me? Boy, you are رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. He's blaming Allah that Allah is laughing. سبحان الله. Well, Allah is getting out from جهنم to put him in جنة. أتهزأ بي وأنت رب العالمين. How يعني? So, are you just Allah? Somehow, يعني, take it easy, عزيز, I'm cool, يعني. And the best thing, if you most beloved to Allah, good deed to Allah, when you make somebody happy. Somehow, with a good word, positive word. Just, سبحان الله, just make it. You're going to make his day. Maybe you're going to give him one word, going to change his mind. His life, we're gonna change his life. Because one word, wallahi al-azim. Subhanallah, but that's why we learn in Islam. وعن رافع بن خديج رضي الله عنه قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. رافع بن خديج, he said, I heard رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, العامل على الصدقة بالحق كالغازي في سبيل الله حتى يرجع إلى بيته. The one, he's collecting صدقة. And he distributing sadaqah with the haqq, with the justice, with the adl, like somebody making jihad fi sabilillah, kalmujahid fi sabilillah. يبقى تحرى الحق وابتغاء وجه الله بالعمل. Whenever you make something, make it in the right way and for the sake of Allah, for the pleasure of Allah. Only thing. Also, من توفيق الله للعبد, الله سبحانه وتعالى is giving you توفيق, هداية, guidance and success. سبحان الله, to read كتاب الله, to recite the Quran and to teach the Quran. خيركم من تعلم القرآن وعلمه, صلى الله عليه وسلم سيدنا. Or to join people for معروف and to forbid them from المنكر. Some of خصال الخير, if you do that. Also, من توفيق الله للعبد, those who have good manners, attitude, أخلاق, conduct with others, يعني أقربكم مني أو أن خياركم أحسنكم أخلاقها. The best of you, those who have, حديث أبو الدرداء, good أخلاق. قال ما من شيء في الميزان أثقل من حسن الخلق. حسن الخلق is very heavy in your scale, حسنات. سبحان الله. He said, صلى الله عليه وسلم, والذي نفسي بيده لا يؤمن عبد حتى يحب لجاره أو قال لأخيه ما يحب لنفسه. Your إيمان, according to this hadith, will not be perfect or in full iman, complete iman, until you love to your neighbor, the hadith, لجاره, or you love to your brother, whatever you love for yourself. You wish for him, whatever, the same like you wish for your own self. Otherwise, your iman will not be perfect. Yes, you have iman, but your iman will be perfect when you wish for your brothers, subhanAllah, whatever you wish for yourself. Also, من علامات توفيق العبد, to be good to your family, حسن عشرة الأهل. To be nice to your wife, your children, your kids. To be good to them, to be generous with them. صلى الله عليه وسلم said that, خيركم خيركم لأهله وأنا خيركم لأهلي. The best, the honorable people amongst you, those who've been honored by Allah, those who are good to their families, to their wives. سبحان الله, and to their children. Very important. Qasim Bhai is looking to Dr. Ibrahim and he's saying, Sheikh is kharban, what he's talking about. Okay. من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. Also, عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. Also, يعني بقول لك يا أخي, بخليك في البزنس تبعك يا عم الحاج. يعني it's not your business, right? صح؟ We heard this from somebody. It's not your business, none of your business. جزاك الله خير يا دكتور. None of your business. This is Islam. من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعنيه. Something is not related to you. Why you put your nose there? يعني see somebody, we talk about مثلا Liverpool today, محمد صلاح and Liverpool. He make him see, makes himself the one he understands. You talk about politics, he said, yes, I am the whatever. You talk about, for example, Islam, he's the best sheikh. You talk about what? He knows everything. سبع صناع والبخت ضايع. You know, he knows everything and he doesn't know nothing. فأنت يعني سبحان الله. And for example, I'm talking about Dr. Ibrahim, with Dr. Ibrahim about something secret. Yeah, and somebody said, oh, what do you think about that? And why you did not do this? It's not your business. And why are you talking? One time, one brother was praying and he was telling me, Sheikh, that's for like 5 years ago. Here, Sheikh, how much money you have in the bank? I told him, why? Really, I was very surprised. How much money you have in the bank? I said, MashaAllah, MashaAllah. What else? Want me to tell you what kind of food I was eating yesterday? What did I do in my house yesterday? This is too much. صح? This is too much. خليك في البزنس تبعك. Stay in your way. Stay in your door. Stay in your business. Don't interfere. This is privacy of others. يا أخي, Muslims, some Muslims like that. يا أخي, this is not good. Be good. That's why من حسن إسلام المرء تركه ما لا يعني. ومن تدخل في ما لا يعني سمع ما لا بس. أيوة, you put your nose in something is not related to the, maybe somebody gonna slap your face. ياخد فوق دماغه على طول. بالظبط كده. بس كده, don't cross the limit with others. Everybody has his own privacy. Except رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. رسول الله, he never hide anything from us. Even in the bathroom, hadith said that. He told us what to do in the bathroom. حتى الخراءة, كان يعلمنا الخراءة. Hadith said that. Even this, he did not hide it from us. صلى الله عليه وسلم. But إحنا, everybody, each one of us has his own privacy, right? صح ولا لا؟ كل واحد عنده بقى السكرت تبعه, الله أعلم what is going on with his secret. He has his own life. But anyway, this is حديث صحابي الجليل أبو دجانة. He mentioned that. هو, let me mention that حديث. ودخل على الصحابي الجليل أبي دجانة بعض أصحابه وهو مريض. أبو دجانة was sick. أبو دجانة was a big fighter. Who knows Abu Dujana? In the battle of what? Can he was wearing العصابة الحمراء, and he was proud while he's riding his horse in the battle of Uhud. And the Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم said, Abu Dujana, هذه مشية يكرهها الله ورسوله إلا في هذا الوقت. Abu Dhabi, I was shown the enemy, how he's very strong. Yeah? Did you see Hogan when he used to put that? Read what? Abu Dhabi was like that, riding his horse, showing with his horse sword his power to the Rasulullah. He said, Allah does not like this kind of walking, but now Allah loves it. Show your enemy how you're strong. Huh? Abu Dhabi, during his time of sickness, what happened to him? Some of his Sahaba, they visit him and they found his face, mashallah, shining. During his time of death, shining. فقيل له ما لوجهك يتهلل. Why your face is good? You're shining. Mashallah, heavy. فقال ما من عمل شيء أوثق عندي من اثنتين. كنت لا أتكلم فيما لا يعنيني والأخرى فكان قلبي للمسلمين سليما. See, I never talk about something is not related to me. And my heart was good toward everybody. I love all Muslims. طيب ما هو both they are related to each others. Imagine if you're putting your nose in each body's business. You're going to fight with everybody. Means you're going to have animosity against people. They're going to have animosity against you. When you know your limits, I never put my nose into somebody's business. That's why my heart was good. My relationship was very good with everybody. That's why that caused him to smile, to have that smile during this time of death. And this is the reason, this is what he said. فهذا يعني سداد من الله سبحانه وتعالى. Also من توفيق الله سبحانه وتعالى العبد. If Allah gives you هدايه and you will be able to say لا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمد رسول الله during your time of death. If Allah gives you that ability to say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله during your time of death, من كان آخر كلامه من الدنيا لا إله إلا الله, what he gonna do? الجنة على طول, direct to جنة. You say شهادة, you die, خلاص you're going to جنة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ya Rabbil Alameen, to give us success dunya and the akhira. To give us tawfiq wa hidayah wa rahmah dunya and the akhira. Rabbana taqabbal minna wa aghfir lana wa rahamna wa saddidna wa thabbit aqdamana ala tariq al-mustaqim ya rahmah rahim wa wahdina wa saddid khutana ya Rabbil Alameen. Wafiqna lima tuhibu wa tardahi ya rahmah rahimin. وفقنا لما تحبه وترضاه يا رب العالمين. ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا وحقق إيماننا وارفع درجتنا. نسألك يا ربنا العلى من الجنة. نسألك موجبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك والسلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى اللهم وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. آمين آمين. نعم.
في الحديث